I'm going to teach you what is known as linear differential equation. Linear differential equation. A differential equation of the form dy by dx plus py is equal to q. What is p and q? They are not numbers. They are not constants. P and q are functions of x. Actually, I should have written dy by dx plus p a function of x into y. Y is not a function of x. Y is single letter y. And q a function of x. Such equations are called linear differential equations. Now I am going to teach you how to solve a linear, how to get the solution of a linear differential equation. After doing that, we will learn that formula and use the formula directly. Suppose I am multiplying both the side by e raised to integral p dx. What will happen? I'm going to write now p only. So I'm going to differentiate and multiply both side with e raised to integral p dx. So this is multiplied. So p will come here. Y will be there and q will be there. Here also integral p dx. So everywhere I multiplied with this first term, I multiplied with e raised to integral p dx. Every term I multiplied. Is that understood? When I do this, what is the benefit that you notice is the left hand side is derivative of y into e raised to integral p dx. Check, is it right or wrong? Apply UV method, first into derivative second plus second into, what is second? Second is y. Y into, what is derivative of e raised to integral p dx? You know that integral of e raised to x only. Integral of e raised to u is e raised to u into derivative of u. Integral and derivative will get cancelled. So only p will be left. That's why you have e raised to integral p dx into p is equal to q e raised to integral p dx. Anybody having doubt, please tell me. Anybody having doubt, please tell me in this step. What did I do first? Multiplied every term with what? E raised to integral p dx. When I do that, the whole left hand side became derivative of y into e raised to integral p dx. How do you differentiate y into integral e raised to p dx? This as it is, derivative of y. Then y as it is, derivative of integral e raised to p dx. Now, to remove this d by dx, I'll integrate both the side. So integral q e raised to integral p dx plus c. This is the solution of a linear differential equation. Now, only one small change I'm going to do is, e raised to integral p dx looks so awkward. So I'm going to call it as integral factor. What I'm calling it? Integral factor. Why do you call it integral factor? By multiplying with this e raised to integral p dx, I am able to integrate it. That's why I'm calling it as integral factor. Sometime in the exam, they only ask what is the integral factor of the differential equation. So integral factor is e raised to integral p dx. So if I call this as integral factor, what will be my answer? The solution of the linear differential equation would be y into integral factor. Y into integral factor is equal to q into integral factor integrated with respect to x plus c. Did you understand this? So once again, if I say this type of equation, what to notice? Y is only once in the equation. This is a technique of deciding whether the equation is linear or not. In the equation, y comes only once, then it is a linear differential equation. Remember, p and x are functions of x. Then what you should do? First, you calculate integral factor. What is the integral factor? E raised to integral p dx. That means y's coefficient will be some x term. That x term comes over here and calculate this. then directly write the solution. You don't have to multiply and show it. Solution of the differential equation is y into integral factor is equal to integral of q into integral factor into dx plus c. So you need to only just integrate this here, and while calculating integral factor also you need to integrate. So let's look at one problem. I'm going to write a direct question. Dy by dx plus y by x is equal to x cube minus 3. You can notice that in this whole equation, however you arrange it, suppose I had arranged it in this way and given x dy by dx plus y is equal to x raised to 4 minus 3x. Still you can make out y is only once, then it's a linear. But this is, they are given it exactly in the format of the linear. It is not necessary they should give you in the format of the linear differential equation. So what do you do? If y occurs only once in the equation, then we can say that this is a linear differential equation. That is an identification of how to find out whether it's a linear or not. Now, after you have written this, so which is a linear differential equation, comparing with, you need to compare with dy by dx plus py equal to q. What is your p? P is your 1 by x. What is your q? X cube minus 3. Agreed, everybody?
Yes.
Now, calculate integral factor. Integral factor is e raised to integral p dx. That is e raised to integral 1 by x dx. You are very happy because e raised to log x. Don't put integral constant here. Just directly integrate it. And that gives you x, such a small integral factor, very easy integral factor. Now, I can write the solution directly. I don't have to do the whole process of finding the solution directly. The solution of the differential equation is y into integral factor is equal to integral of q into integral factor dx plus c. Y into x, integral factor is x, is equal to q. Where is q? This is q. X cube minus 3 into x, which is this x, the integral factor x, dx plus c. So xy is equal to integral x raised to 4 minus 3x into dx plus c. So xy is equal to x raised to 5 upon 5 minus 3x square upon 2 plus c. If you feel like, you can divide by x and make y as a subject. So y is x raised to 4 upon 5 minus 3x upon 2 plus c by x is the general solution. That is up to you, whether to make y as a subject or not. It is up to you. You can write the answer in this format. Your test book also gave you. Your test book is given in this format. Your test book is given in this format. But usually, it's better to make y as a subject. Have you understood, everybody?
Yes, sir.
Can you practice one question yourself? Okay, I'm writing next question. Question number 2.